We can't talk about Colin Powell without talking about his legacy as a Secretary of State and the Iraq War of 2003. It's been talked about so much. Lawrence Korb was saying to us earlier about how the speech that he gave to the United Nations was actually toned down from what his bosses wanted. But even so, it leaves that mark. It is what people will, certainly as his diplomatic career goes, they will go back to.
Well, certainly, you know, there are two bookends when it comes to Colin Powell in Iraq. I served as a military officer during the first Gulf War, where the United States, under his leadership, acted decisively, acted in concert with other regional powers, international powers, to drive the Iraqi army out of Kuwait. I think he then suffered from groupthink, you know, together with some of his other colleagues on the national security team. They felt earnestly, based on their previous history, that, you know, Saddam Hussein, you know, was hiding something, and in spite of the slim evidence that he was. But then again, you know, to his credit, he was accountable. You know, he admitted, you know, his mistakes, later. That is not something that we've heard across the Bush national security team.